He never killed anybody. So you haven't read Muhammad at all.
I have, right?
Oh my God.
I didn't read it the way you read it. I said.
So why do you have to get in face?
The issue is that you are claiming that the Prophet,
what?
Prophet peace be upon him, yes, killed 600 to 900 Jews.
You agree with that, yeah?
Did he do that, yes or no?
Let's say argument say yes.
No argument.
Argument
say, no, I don't want to hear argument say. Did he do it, yes or no?
He killed a specific amount of Jews. We don't know the number.
Okay. No, we do. Let's
read it. Argument say 600. No problem. I accept.
So you accept he did.
I accept.
Okay.
No.
Okay. So
he didn't go and kill them himself.
Brother, did he?
God. Look, if I'm debating this with
you know, what would we do, Ali? Yeah? Let the text speak. Go read.
Are you going to text? Yeah?
Read it.
Woo!
I'm ready. Okay. Then they surrendered, and the apostle confined them in Medina, in the quarter of Di al-Harith, a woman of Bi al-Najir. Then the apostle went out to the market of Medina and dug trenches in it. I'll pause so you know you get what I'm talking about. Then he sent for them and struck off their heads in those trenches as they were brought out to him in batches. Among them was the enemy of Allah, Huwai bin al-Khattab and Ka'b, Asad their chief. They were 600 or 700 in all, though some people put the figure as high as 800 or 900.
Finish?
Shall I continue? Are you getting
finished? I've got it fully. Like, you know when you have nutrition, yeah, it slowly goes into your body. I've got it fully.
Okay,
yeah?
All right.
Now I'm going to give the fruits of the nutrition.
No, okay. I haven't finished. Finished.
Okay, then finish. Why
tell me? So it gets into your head. As they were being taken out in batches to the apostle, they asked what he thought would be done with them. He replied, will you never understand? Don't you see that the summoner never stops and those who are taken away do not return? And then it went on to say, then he went to the men and said, God's command is right. A book and a decree and a massacre have been written against the sons of Israel. Then he finishes off by saying, then he sat down and his head was struck off.
Okay.
Ibn Ishaq, The Life of Muhammad, page 461 to 464. That is your prophet.
That's your prophet.
Yeah, well, like
that. Do you agree with that?
That is my prophet. Peace be upon him against his enemies 100%. 1,000,000,000%.
That
look, I'll tell you very clearly again.
I didn't say that.
That is my prophet.
Did you listen to what
I was about to say? I was about to call you.
Did you
really? No, but you need to give us proof.
Deal with the king.
I am.
So where's the enemy?
I am. One second. Is that my prophet 1,000,000,000%? Against his enemies 1,000,000,000%. That's my prophet.
Don't embarrass your Muslim friends.
Just the way. When Jesus says he's going to come back and he says, those who do not let me reign over them, bring them here and kill them.
Okay,
his enemies.
We moved
there. And I say to Jesus, we'll, you know what? I respect because they're your enemies.
We'll
no
move there. Now, no, don't twist our scripture. Yeah, we'll move there.
Yeah, but
don't lie. You need to deal with the Muhammad.
We've answered
deal with
the question.
Muhammad. I am. Yeah.
Be sincere.
Show us that these were his enemies.
The only reason I have this, because Daniel,
can you say my name properly, bro?
Sorry.
My name is Daniel. Not Daniel. Like a woman.
Daniel. Is that okay? Okay, sorry, forgive me.
Thank you.
I'm not saying on purpose. I don't do it on purpose.
Thank you, Ali.
Daniel. Yeah? What I'm saying is the reason why 2 or 3 weeks ago you got disqualified, yeah, by me, yeah, because you quoted a verse, chapter 60, verse 8, and the very following verse was debunking your case, and that was embarrassing for me because you know what, the fact that you
deal
didn't do your homework,
deal,
yeah?
Deal with this, bro.
So therefore I give you another chance. You came very, very firm and strong in your argument, yeah, and
as I always do.
The funny thing is this, yeah, if the jizya issue, me and him was going to debate. I'm just going to come on, yeah? The reason I said to him, I said, give me 2 weeks. And then even the second week, I said, give me another week, yeah? Because when I don't know the topic, I say, look, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. With this one, why did I come and say to you, let's debate it? Because you are lacking information. Number one.
You're kind of rambling
question,
a bit.
Simple question.
You're rambling.
Have you heard of Banu Qaynuqa? Banu Nadir? And?
Banu Qanaiza.
Banu Qurayza. Look at this guy. Brothers, you need to be like, look, he knows it better. Banu Qurayza, Banu Nadir, and Banu Qaynuqa. Okay. Have you heard of these three tribes?
Them? What about them?
Have you heard of them?
Yeah.
Okay, who are they?
Well, why don't you ask
them? No, but it's related to this. It's related.
No.
Deal with this.
No.
Then you deal with it.
Deal with this, brother. Deal with this.
Why not agree arguments say that 600 Jews will be headed?
Yeah, you said they were his enemies.
Explain. Don't ask
questions. Ali, you said they were his enemies.
Yeah.
Show us.
I am.
These Jews were the enemies. Show us.
I am.
Don't ask me questions.
Don't ask Christians.
Okay.
Answer.
Okay, no problem. Yeah, because they know they don't have the knowledge, Banu Nadir, Banu Qaynuqa, and Banu Qurayza, there was three attempted assassinations of the Prophet, Number one, they tried to throw a rock over his head,
And a what? A what?
Big rock, yeah? They tried to throw a rock over his head.
This is the Ali Dawa version.
We'll find out, no problem. If I'm making this up, I'm going to be exposed. If I'm making this up, I'm going to be a liar. They tried to throw a rock on his head.
No, give us evidence. Revelation. Don't lie to the people. Go on, we'll bring evidence.
So, therefore, they tried to throw it.
This is Surah
revelation,
Ali.
Revelation.
Surah Ayah Dawa.
I got it all here, Revelation came down warning the Prophet. The Prophet moved away,
Let's see.
Did he kill them? No. He said, you're being exiled. You broke the treaty. We had a treaty. We're going to live in peace, We're going to have a treaty. They broke it. The Prophet killed them. He had the right to kill them. He said, I'm exiling you. Bye-bye. I think it was Banu Nadir. Banu Qurayza or Banu Qaynuqa, I think they tried to poison the Prophet, peace be upon him. Okay. What did the Prophet do? Again, he exiled them. He said, get lost. Bearing in mind, there is other Jews who are sticking to the treaty and the Prophet's living peacefully with them. Banu Qurayza, what did Banu Qurayza do? Do you know the Battle of the Trench?
What about it?
Do you know the Battle of the Trench?
Okay, but that. Okay.
Do you know what happened?
Bro,
do you know what happened?
Bro, I don't know why you're asking questions when I'm expecting you to deal with this.
You don't know. Yeah.
Why are you not dealing with this?
Can you deal with
why
it?
Why are you not dealing with this? I just want to
see,
know.
See, Muslims who why can actually see deeper. In this conversation, those who can see deeper in this conversation, Ali Dawa is trying to deviate from the main topic, trying to big himself up, saying, I know knowledge. Deal why Muhammad killed 600 to 900 Jews in one afternoon.
Look, he asked me a question, If I say, why did he punch you in the face, you're going to say, let me tell you how it started, Let me tell you how it started.
Yeah, but you're not telling me.
I am.
No, you're not. That's not what you're telling me.
I am. This is the Battle of Trench. This is what
they have. Okay, sources. Give us your sources.
Okay, go look at the seerah.
No, give us your sources. Right here. I'm right here.
Listen.
I've got the seerah here. Ibn Hisham, page 461 to page 464. Here it is. I've got it here. And he killed them because they opposed Allah.
No.
Here. By God, I do not blame myself for opposing you.
No.
Look, but he who forsakes God will be forsaken. Nothing to do with being enemies.
Nothing to do with enemies.
Let me finish. The Battle of the Trench is when the pagans came to attack the Prophet, peace be upon him. Yeah, okay.
Can you finish up?
Hassan.
Where they came to attack.
Let me finish.
Yeah? You can finish. Are you going to show us the source?
Listen.
Are you going to show us the source?
The source.
The source of what you're talking about. What
Surah Al-Azab, verse 26, he brought down those of the people of the book who backed them, the pagans, from their fortresses and cast terror in their hearts. Mm-hmm. A party you were slain and a party you taken captive. Who's this talking about?
So, you're going to Surah 33 while I'm reading
Ibn Hisham. Look, Tafsir ibn Kathir, that's the Quran.
I knew he was going to deviate this guy.
No, look.
Why are you reading Surah 33?
Nobody talk. The allusion is to Banu Qurayza, one of the three. Listen, the three major Jewish tribes inhabiting in the vicinity of Medina in well-built fortresses. Why was this revelation revealed? Because when the pagans came to attack the Prophet, peace be upon him, they backstabbed the Prophet and did what? Joint alliances. When the pagans said, sorry, we can't do anything, the wind came, we're going, they were stuck. Now they broke the treaty. And this is an agreement. If Britain has a treaty with Russia and breaks it, night-night is war. It is war.
Can I show how you're lying?
Let me finish.
How long do you need?
I'm nearly finished. So now, one second, let me scroll to the verse.
Because you're not dealing with it in the shop.
Look. Give me one second. Okay, this is Surah Maida verse 32 to 34, yeah? Go to number 33. Indeed, the penalty for those who wage war against Allah and His Messenger and strive upon the earth to cause corruption is none but they be killed or crucified, or that their hands and feet be cut off on opposite sides, or they be exiled. Or they be exiled from the land. That is for them a disgrace in this world, and for them in the hereafter is a great punishment.
What is the tafsir on that? You know that's going to debunk you.
No, it's not.
Because you deviated. So let me deal with that as well.
Let me finish.
What does tafsir Ibn Kathir say?
The tafsir says this is mentioning one of the four possibilities. Either the pagans, either the Jewish tribes who betrayed the Prophet, or highway robbers, be they Muslim or non-Muslim. What does
corruption mean? What does
corruption? Corruption.
He didn't address that. So I'm gonna have to address. I'm gonna address your other lies.
Okay, read 33. Read 33.
So basically, he's not addressing Ibn Hisham. Yeah. He went straight to Surah 5. I don't know what Ali's doing. I don't know how the hell he has more than 300,000 followers. It's impossible to follow a guy like this with a great mind in your...
Hater.
Anyways, watch this.
Don't hate me because you hate me.
No, I don't understand you. Yeah.
Read 13. So don't mind the verse first.
So you've ignored that.
So you've ignored this. I agreed.
I said, what happened?
This is not the correct thing to kill these people.
Then, what happened? The Prophet, peace be upon him, went to their fortresses. They didn't come out. So he said, either come out, they waited for about 30 days, 40 days. They eventually came out. Look at the mercy of the Prophet. He could have easily said, night, night.
You're making things up.
What did he say? He said, who do you want? Listen, check this out. You can check facts, yeah? You're recording. I'm going to send you the information, yeah? The Jews came and said, we want somebody, Sa'd ibn Mu'ad, yeah? We want him, radiallahu anh, to judge between us. The Prophet said, no problem. The Prophet called Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. He came, and Sa'd ibn Mu'ad was one of their friends before, the Jews' friends, yeah? And he was injured in the battle. He said, every single man who was involved, behead them. And all the women and children are captives. And this is by the order of the who? The Jews, they specifically asked for Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. Yeah? They specifically asked for Sa'd ibn Mu'ad, yeah? Sa'd ibn Mu'ad came, gave the verdict, and 600 to 900, or how many, Jews were executed, the men.
That's not what it says. You have to read. I've read what it says. And they were opposing Allah. But you know what you're talking about? It's got nothing to do with what it says.
Ali, don't be off somewhere else. Did you understand when he said, they did that because they were opposing Allah? What does that mean to you?
In what way?
What way?
They were opposing Allah. They never fought Muhammad.
Okay, what does it say?
They didn't have time to fight Muhammad, brother.
They didn't have time to fight Muhammad.
They were opposing Allah, and he who forsakes God will be forsaken.
So what did he say?
So there is a massacre written against the sons of Israel.
Yes.
Then he sat down and his head was struck off. Right.
The Jews. Yes.
Yes, because they opposed Allah.
Nothing to do with fighting Muhammad.
Let's see if you have your facts here. Did this occur because of the Battle of Trench or no?
No.
I dare you to prove it. I would become a Christian.
I just said to you.
I will become a Christian now.
Okay.
I testify on camera.
Did you hear what I said?
One second. Look, I'm so certain. I will become a Christian right now. I'll testify.
No, you won't. You see, every week you don't become a Christian.
We proved it because your argument was weak. I dare you. Bring me evidence that this beheading that happened of 600 Jews, and this is specific, the rest of the Jews were okay with the Prophet. It didn't happen because of the Battle of Trench. I dare you.
Okay.
Triple dare.
Basically, he's thrown. Is that a tasbih or is that hadith?
No. I've read it. So you want me to read it again?
I beg you answer.
So you haven't been listening to what I've read.
600 Jews were beheaded because of the Battle of Trench. Answer. I agree. I accept 600 Jews, but the Prophet, peace be upon him, ordered Sa'd ibn Mu'ad to come. Please tell me that wasn't related to the Battle of Trench.
So this is what you're saying. Then they sent for them and struck off their heads in those trenches.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
As they were brought out to him in batches.
Yes.
Why did he struck their head off?
Because they betrayed him.
It doesn't say that.
Where did you get that from? Read it. What did it say?
They betrayed him.
How do you come here unarmed? Are you
serious?
You need to be armed intellectually.
You're looking very...
Let the viewers decide. I dare you to prove to me that this wasn't because of the treaty.
We just read it to you.
Look. Indeed, the penalty for those who wage war against Allah and His Messenger. War. Come on, man.
Brother.
Daniel, please.
Yeah, say it right.
Daniel, please don't. Look, when you come and confront us, at least do your research.
I have.
You're not going to upload this. I know you're not. But we are. Do not do this to yourself, Daniel. Look, when I come to you, I make sure I know my stuff. If I don't know, look, he came to me with a jizzy. I think I didn't know. I said, Daniel, give me 3 weeks. Yeah.
I can't even see now. So, okay, sin of. Okay, let's go. Let's go with Banu Qurayza. Yeah. Narrated Aisha, when Allah's apostle returned on the day of Al-Kadak, i.e. the trench, yes. Yeah, he put down his arms. I'm going to read, you're going to test Ali Dawa for yourself now. Ali Dawa was going to be put to test right now. Watch this, yeah? Put down his arms and took a bath. Then Gabriel, whose head was covered with dust, came to him saying, you have put down your arms. By Allah, I have not put down my arms yet. Allah's apostle said, where to go? Gabriel said, this way, put towards the tribe of Banu Qurayza.
Yes.
So Allah's apostle went towards them.
Yes.
So why did he go towards them?
Because they broke the treaty.
Did I say that?
They broke the treaty.
Sahih al-Bukhari, does he say that? Not me, sorry. Not me. I don't talk for myself. Does Sahih al-Bukhari say that?
Are you making this stuff up?
That's Sahih al-Bukhari.
You guys are mad.
Are you making this stuff up?
So he's been put in the test. He failed the test.
These guys are mad.
He failed the test.
I cannot believe.
Where does it say that? Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 4, book 52, number 68. Go and read it for yourself.
This is embarrassing.
I give you sources.
Ali Dawa doesn't have sources.
This is embarrassing.
Give us one source here.
I give the Quran. Go to the Sirah.
Surah 5 has nothing to do with this. Surah 533, what he quoted, wait, let me explain what he quoted. What he quoted, Surah 533 to 38, is about thieves and murderers.
Yes.
How you cut their hands off, cut their feet off, and crucify them.
Yes.
But these Jews are not thieves and murderers. They just opposed Allah. That's all they've done. And Muhammad killed them.
How?
One afternoon.
Why?
What do you mean why?
Why
they opposed Allah.
It just seems ready.
Prove to me that this was enough to do with the Battle of Trench. I swear, I'll put my hands down.
You know who you remind me of?
I am ready to accept Christianity.
You remind me of
the Pharisees
and the scribes.
Yeah. Forget that.
Yeah. Where
you remind
Jesus
me of a horror
said,
movie.
Those who have ears to hear, let them hear.
Answer my question.
You're just listening.
Please,
you're not hearing.
Please answer me.
That's your problem.
Please, I beg you answer.
I have answered. What do you want me to say?
Just tell me that this has got nothing to do with the Battle of Trench. I submit. You're right. You're right, I'm wrong. Ali, look.
Ali Dawa.
I am wrong.
Ali Dawa. Ali Dawa.
Please.
Ali Dawa. Wait. The point here is,
please just show me.
If it's the Battle of the Trench, or the Battle of the Banu Qurayza, or the other battle, that's not the point here. The point here is, the reason Muhammad killed these people is because they opposed Allah. They were never fighting. I just read it. Okay, put your light back on. By God, I do not blame myself for opposing you. This is the Jew talking to Muhammad. But he who forsakes God will be forsaken.
Opposing in what?
I'm just answering
you. Okay, can I oppose you?
I'm answering you.
Can I oppose you intellectually? I'm forsaking God.
That's what he says. He who forsakes God will be forsaken.
What does that mean?
So the Jew forsook God. So what did Muhammad do?
No.
So finish.
No. Let me ask you a question. When I oppose you, no problem. You can do your fact check. Just write. It's very simple.
What do you want to say?
Look, Banu Qurayza, the Battle of Trench. Very simple. Everybody knows this.
The Battle of Trench. We just read it. Yeah.
Very easy. Yeah. I'm asking a simple question. Yeah. This, whichever government, if the treaty is broken and they've been backstabbed, what is the punishment for that?
You're not comparing. You're comparing apples and bananas.
This is apples and apples.
How is it apples and apples?
Please answer. What happens to them?
Go on, say the question again.
If we are allying with Russia and we say if America attack you, we're behind you, we got your back, but we backstab them, what is the punishment for treason?
It depends what their constitution
says. What is the punishment? Let's say it's death.
It depends what the constitution says.
What if it's death and beheaded?
Okay, yeah, that's what happens.
Thank you.
But that's not what happened with Muhammad.
Thank you.
Viewers, if you think that what he just said is right, Muhammad is saying they forsook God.
No.
There!
They broke the treaty.
What do you want me to read?
You know what? Ali Dawa. You don't even know. You're doing some homework.
I have here is
Daniel,
it.
Before you come here, I might see Ali Dawa today. Let me do some homework.
No, I don't need to do homework for you.
You need to study the better Battle of the Trench. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh is one of the companions the Jews asked for a verdict. He came and said, behead all of them.
Okay, Ali without...
Do you know that?
Okay, without deviating.
Look, Sa'd ibn Mu'ad was in the battle. His arm, he lost his arm because of the Jews, what they did, yeah? He was the verdict the Jews asked for. Did you know this?
Can you show us?
Do you know this?
No, I didn't know. Can you show us?
So at least...
No, but don't deviate. Without deviating.
Look.
These 600 Jews... These 600...
No, Ibn Mu'ad. Look,
Ali Dawa, man. This is what I don't like. He deviates so much.
The 600 to 900 Jews that were killed... Ali Dawa explicitly show me where it says they were fighting Muhammad.
No problem.
Explicit word. You know how you come and say, where did Jesus say, I'm God, worship me?
The question is back on you now.
Yeah? Where does it say explicitly that they were fighting Muhammad? This is why he was fighting. Don't go to Wikipedia, bro.
No. That's what came out.
Wikipedia is not a good source.
Mr. Wikipedia.
Which battle was this?
Sorry?
Okay. Which battle?
Trench.
1 second. The battle of trench.
The battle of
trench.
What they did.
No. I know. Everybody knows this.
What did they do?
So, look. What's your question?
My question is, did Muhammad kill 600 to 900 Jews because they were fighting him or because they opposed God?
No, not because they oppose God.
Okay, your source says they oppose God, that's why.
No.
Ibn Hisham, page 461 to 464. Did you listen to the source?
Who's Ibn Hisham?
The life of Muhammad. That's the biography of Muhammad.
Which biography?
The life of Muhammad.
Listen, know your facts. There's different sources. You can't get a book and read up any facts. Give me a hadith or ayah from the Quran.
Brother.
Don't get a book.
You want hadith?
Get a hadith.
You know hadith?
Give me a hadith.
Hadith is different from the life of Muhammad. Did you know that?
Okay. Give me a hadith.
I got it. Brother, please.
Brother, please. You don't know what you're talking about.
We're talking.
Give me a hadith.
Okay.
Don't bring Ibn Hisham.
So you put Ibn Hisham under the bus.
Give me Sahih Bukhari. Give me Sahih Bukhari.
All right, I will. Wait. Let me deal with Ali Dawa first. I've got five Sahih Bukharis here, brother.
I've got one as well, Sahih Bukhari.
Let me deal with him first. Show us. Explicit words.
Don't bring these.
Wait, brother, wait. Respect Ali. Can you respect him?
Brother, please.
Can you respect him, yeah? I want to listen to what he says. Explicit words.
Volume 5, book 58, number 148.
Volume 5.
Narrated by Sayyid al-Qudri. Yeah?
What is it? Sahih al-Bukhari?
Sahih al-Bukhari.
What is this about?
Some people, i.e. the Jews of Banu bin Qurayza, agreed to accept the verdict of Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. Firstly, the question that needs to be asked is, why are they accepting the verdict? For what? What is the verdict being applied for? So, verdict of Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. So the Prophet sent, so they broke the treaty. So the Prophet peace be upon him came and said,
What did you say to the text? Before you do any commentary.
If Jay Smith sees this, he's going to have a big go at you. You guys are stupid. Okay. Do some homework.
Okay.
Jay Smith's going to be so upset with you guys.
Okay. No, Jesus won't be upset.
No. Jay Smith, he's going to be so angry.
Doesn't matter what Jay Smith says. As long as Jesus.
I am. One second.
Even your Muslim brother, say you're also the question.
Ali, that's the reason I can. Please,
Ali. Now, finish reading. And then you can comment.
Let me finish. Yeah.
Finish reading.
Let me finish,
Your commentary at the end, brother.
So the
please.
Prophet sent for him, Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. He came riding a donkey. And when he approached the mosque, the Prophet said, get up for the best amongst you. Yeah? Or said, get up for your chief. Then the Prophet said, oh Sa'd, these people have agreed to accept your verdict. Sa'd said, I judge. This is Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. It's between them Jews. The Sa'd ibn Mu'ad and Jews.
Yeah, we know.
Okay. I judge that they're warriors. Warriors? What's a warrior? Is a warrior who just opposes? Warriors should be killed and take their children and women should be taken as captives.
Uh-huh.
The Prophet said, you have given a judgment similar to Allah's judgment for the kings of judgment.
You haven't
shown anything. Now.
Don't go to another one.
Deal with that one. You're making our point for us.
Viewers, please don't follow this guy. He's lying. Deception to the max. To the max.
Tell him to bring the evidence, what he said. He has to bring it to the max.
I did. I've been reading it for 10 minutes.
Sorry, that's a biography. That's not evidence. I know Ali, but what I'm saying is keep it simple.
So the biography, you put it under the bus.
No, the biography comes from the
hadith. You put it under the bus.
This is not hadith.
Bro, I am giving that. one by one. I'll give you one by one. Bring calm down.
Aki, he's giving
numbers. I need to deal with it first.
I'm telling you, keep it simple. You don't need to, Aki, believe don't need to go to Al-Aqwa.
No.
This is how Muslims say, bring it.
Why are you going to argue with each other?
Aki, there you go. Do you see that?
Because you're not bringing
him forward. Brother. This is what they're going to do. Aki, this is what they're
going to do. Calm down. Calm down, sir. We're going to expose it slowly. Calm down. Why do you want to be exposed so quickly?
Because you know what?
Brother, yeah, I can. Brother, slowly, though. No. I want to do it slow.
Falling into their trap. Brother, you're falling into the trap.
Don't put your life on it.
Brother, you're falling into the trap. Just 1 second.
Go on. Ali, stay with the topic, please.
When the tribe of Banu Qurayza was ready to accept Sa'd's judgment, Allah's apostle sent for Sa'd, who was near to him. Sa'd came riding. The same thing. Same narration.
Yeah, but it's got nothing to do with the 600 Jews, is it?
No.
600 to 900 Jews.
No. What I'm saying to you is, now, can you prove to me, because Sa'd ibn Mu'adh came and said, kill the warriors. He did not say to you, opposing Allah's messenger. He said, kill the warriors. What is a warrior?
Yeah,
why are you waffling?
What is a warrior?
Why are you waffling?
What's a warrior?
That has got nothing to do.
What is a warrior? Sa'd ibn Mu'adh said, kill the warriors.
Okay, a warrior is someone who fights. But was that my question?
Was that my question?
My question was, where does it say explicitly? What was my question? Okay. Anyone that was listening, what was my question?
Warrior?
You haven't even listened to my question.
What is a warrior?
And you're laughing on when he says night.
What's a warrior?
It's embarrassing, you're following this guy.
What's a warrior?
My question is, where does it say explicitly 600 to 900 Jews were being killed by fighting Muhammad?
There is no such number, but we know they got beheaded.
No, you agree to it.
I said argument sake, less than 600.
You agree to it.
They are enemies of the Prophet and they got killed.
Show us that they were fighting Muhammad. Show us.
The warriors should be killed. What's a warrior?
No, that's a different context.
Be answered. Be around the bush.
Is that the Battle of Trench?
Be around the bush.
Is that the Battle of Trench?
Sa'd ibn Mu'adh.
Is that the Battle of Trench?
Yes.
Show me.
Yes.
Show me. Where does it say Battle of Trench? Show me. No. Go to the same hadith. That's how you know this guy's lying. Go to the same hadith. Where does it say that?
If I do, are you going to apologize?
That doesn't say.
If I do, are you going to apologize?
Bro, show me.
If I show, I'm going to say sorry.
You're not going to show me.
I'm going to say sorry. You're not going to show me. Give me another chance. I'm going to say that.
Because you went out of the same hadith. Go to the same hadith.
What happened?
Go to the same hadith.
What happened?
My brother's going to Google and Googling Muhammad.
I know that.
This is embarrassing.
Watch this, guys. Battle of?
Embarrassing.
Watch this. I want an apology.
I don't need to apologize to you.
Watch this.
Bro, you're going to Google. Camera, get this guy. What he's doing. Look what he's doing here. He's not even going to sources.
No.
Why did you go on your own
sources? This is the best source ever.
No, the one you just read.
Better than ketchup.
Exposed again.
After the Battle of Uhud, Abu Sufyan and the other pagan leaders realized that they had fought an indecisive action and their victory had not been born to any fruits for them. Islam had in fact realized from his reverse at Uhud. The pagans considered Islam a threat to their economic security and the political supremacy in Arabia, and they could never be reconciled to its existence. They knew if they could kill Muhammad, the interest would be safeguarded and their head would be restored in Arabia. With this aim, they decided to strike a final and a crushing blow at Medina and to exterminate all Muslims.
What source is that?
I'm going to give you the
No, give me the source. You want me to apologize? Yeah, give me the source. Give me the source. What's the source? No, you're lying. I can see you're lying.
You know you're going to apologize.
No, I'm never going to apologize.
Watch.
Because you just lied.
Okay, 1 second. I'm going to find you the best.
What is the source? Is that Sahih al-Bukhari? Is that Ibn Shah?
In 2 years, the Quraysh raised a fighting force of 10,000 warriors. This is warriors, yeah? Not anything else.
It's got nothing to do with what I'm saying.
This was the largest force ever assembled by the Arabs to that day, with great fanfare and aplomb. Yeah? Now, let's go here.
Alida was struggling. He's struggling. He can't even find it.
Don't worry.
They keep asking Christians, where does it say in the Bible, Jesus says, I am God? The question is back at them. Explicitly, how did Muhammad kill the 600 and 900 Jews? Why did he kill them? Because they opposed Allah.
Now, this is a verse, this is a clear-cut verse about the Battle of Trench. Behold, this is a clear verse from Surah chapter 33, verse 10.
Why are you going to Surah chapter 33?
This is the Battle of Trench. Behold, they came upon you from above you.
I'm into taking. So
Baba's calling you too much.
You wish he kept calling. that came on you from above you and from below you. And behold, the eyes became dim and the hearts grieved the throat of the... And you imagine where it is today. So the Muslims were scared. Behind them is Ben Qurayza. Yeah? In front of us is the...
Where did I just say that?
Now, listen. Behold,
a party...
Check this out. It's the Quran.
You're giving us your own tafsir.
Behold, a party among them said, you men of Yathrib, you cannot stand the attack. Therefore, go back and band of them ask for leave of the Prophet, saying, truly our house are bare and exposed. Though they were not exposed.
Where is it then?
One second.
If you can't show us, just say I don't know.
I am.
You're worse than you.
Listen.
And then he gets exposed.
Listen.
And then you get exposed. And you still lie.
No. I feel sorry for you guys. That's why you don't... You don't really see what you're doing. In Jesus, there's no deception.
We worship the one Jesus.
Come to Jesus Christ.
We already have
the light of the world. Who is Jesus? The way, the truth, and the life. Muhammad is. Look what you're doing. Look what Muhammad is making you do. You can't even find.
No, it is here. It's right here. Muhammad is making me. It's right here. You don't need to go anywhere. Life of Muhammad, 461-464.
Ali Dawa, struggling over and over again. Shall I give you another?
I just want my apology. Do not say you need to go.
Apology for what? I'm not going to go. What time is it? No, we got time. Good. I'm not going
to go. Let me find you the exact source.
I feel sorry for you, man. You keep going from source to source and you can't find it. Embarrassing.
I'm going to eventually find it.
Muslims, I beg you, leave Islam and come to Jesus.
Why? You're going to be begging for a long time.
Because that is where life is. In Islam, there's no life. In Islam, there's no life. There's no life, brother. If you leave Islam, what is the punishment? What is the punishment?
What is the punishment?
Get the punishment.
For leaving Islam.
Forget the punishment. Exactly. Okay, no. I'll tell you what the punishment
That's
is.
Why you're not leaving Islam.
Listen, don't try to understand the fruits, but understand the roots. That's what you're
saying. Yeah, the roots.
But you don't understand.
The roots are stinking.
No. You don't.
The roots of Islam are stinking.
Okay, good. Tell me.
Okay, Mama, one second.
You can't even talk about it. You can abuse, but without talking about it.
Surah 489, Sahih al-Bukhari 69:22, Sahih al-Bukhari 51:58.
What context?
I can give you so many things. Surah 9:29. Surah 973.
Aki, this is what he wants.
In what context?
This is what he wants.
Baby, you have to ask him certain questions.
Brother, allow me. Don't allow me.
He can't answer it.
Aki, allow me. Brother, allow me. Please, I beg you. I beg you. My friend. My friend. Aki, please. I beg you. Wallahi. Here, Daniel.
You're talking about Jesus.
Okay, we're going to give you... It is the year 627 AD.
What happened in 627?
All the sources are here.
What happened in 627?
After 5 Hijrah, somewhere between February and March, the Meccans have...
February? is that Sahih al-Bukhari? Sahih al-Bukhari said February and March.
Why are you laughing at the name of the month?
No. Sahih al-Bukhari does not know February and March. Or he might know, but there's nothing called February and March in Sahih al-Bukhari.
Daniel, I just want my apology. Let me just finish.
Okay, the
battle of the trench, yeah? Okay, let's listen, yeah? It is here that Muhammad and his troops now turn towards Ben Qurayza. Yeah? The third largest and richest of the three Jewish tribes of Medina. The other two, the Banu Qaynuqa and Banu Nadir, they were exiled. They're gone, yeah?
For what reason?
They were gone because they tried to kill the Prophet.
He doesn't say that.
Having been banished from Medina earlier. However, listen carefully. The Banu Qurayza were not as lucky as the other two. According to some of the earliest Muslim historians and commentators, Ibn Ishaq, Al-Waqidi, Al-Tabari, and Ibn Kathir, yeah, you happy? The Banu Qurayza were besieged for 25 days by the Muslims, led by Muhammad. Quranic passages from chapter 33, which I was quoting, refer to the incident. Although in more oblique manner, hadith collections such as Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, and Sunan Abu Dawud also give narratives of the event. After the final surrender of Banu Qurayza, ditches were dug and the men between 680, which you're quoting, of them were buried in, they were beheaded and buried in them.
While their children were 600 to 800 of them with tied shoulders.
Beheaded. Beheaded.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But were beheaded and then buried in them. So show us where these people were fighting Muhammad.
My friend.
Show us.
I think I'm talking to a brick wall. It's very clear. Anybody.
Does it say that?
it's just like, I didn't.
Oh, does it say they were fighting Muhammad?
What's the next question? Is it still the same?
Why were they besieged?
Listen to him.
Still on that point.
Listen to him. Listen to him. Were the 600 Jews fighting Muhammad? Is that why he killed him? The Battle of Trenches?
Anybody?
Can you show me they were fighting Muhammad?
No, you know why?
No. I don't want your opinion.
Come say from a hadith.
No, no, your opinion.
Oh, you don't know the truth.
No, I don't want your opinion.
Scared of the truth.
I want a source. Give me a source.
I'll give you the hadith.
Where?
I'll give it. I don't have it on me. I'll give you the hadith.
What hadith?
I'll tell you the hadith.
You have so many hadiths.
I'll tell you the hadith.
Bukhari has nine volumes.
Can you now?
Can you show me the source?
Can you now apologize?
You're scared of the truth.
Can you now apologize?
I have the truth.
Can you now apologize?
There's no apology.
Ibn Ishaq, Tabari, all of them. This is a fact. This is so embarrassing.
They said that they were fighting Muhammad. No.
Your head teacher, Jay Smith, even knows this. If you go to him, he's going to slap you and say, you idiot.
Jay Smith is not my head teacher.
You fool. How do you go? Listen, you're an absolute idiot. Jay Smith will be so angry with you.
Jay Smith is my brother in Christ.
I need to ask you a question.
Your brother in Christ is going to slap you up. He's going to say, how are you going to Ali Dawa and not knowing that the Battle of Trench is directly linked with Banu Qurayza and them breaking the treaty?
Why were the Jews besieged?
That's not what I'm talking about. Show me where they were fighting Muhammad.
Ali, why were the Jews besieged?
I keep asking the same question over and over again.
Very simple. Google Battle of Trench, Banu Qurayza.
Google.
Simple.
Google. I've got the life of Muhammad here.
Apologize.
Why were the Jews besieged?
For what?
I'll forgive you.
No,
nobody needs to die for your sins. I don't need. Nobody's going to die. He has died.
And he's resurrected and he's my savior. He can be yours too.
Apologize. I'm gonna
if you surrender your heart.
Allah says Allah will not forgive those who do not forgive others. I'm gonna forgive
Allah
you.
Doesn't apologize. Exist. Allah
say
doesn't
apologize.
Exist.
Say sorry.
I'm not gonna say sorry.
I'm not gonna say sorry.
Ali Dawa does not have the sources. Ali Dawa have the sources.
Bro.
Let's read.
Do your homework.
Let's move on because he doesn't know. He doesn't have the sources. Let's read the mercy to mankind. Do you believe Muhammad is a mercy to mankind?
He's the best thing for mankind ever.
Okay, let's read what he did in Bukhari. Yeah? Narrated Abu Kilaba. No. It's another one. It's right here.
Anyone that breaks a treaty, treason, night. No, anywhere in the world.
Listen,
America.
Listen what they did. The news reached the Prophet early in the morning and he sent in their pursuit. They captured them and brought them at noon.
Yes.
He then ordered to cut their hands off.
Yes.
And their eyes were branded with heated piece of iron.
Where's that from?
Number
where's
two.
The sauce?
Sahel Bukhari.
Let me see it. Watch
volume
it.
One.
Let me see it.
You will see it. Yes. I'm giving it to you. So the people can listen. Sahel Bukhari. Volume one. Book 234.
This is
the mercy to mankind. The mercy to mankind. What did he do? He cut their hands off.
And then?
And he put heated piece of iron in their eyes. And then, wait, it gets worse. It gets worse.
Yeah, what did
it
do?
It gets worse.
Watch this.
They were put in Al-Hara, wherever that is.
Yeah.
And then, this was very hot desert in Mecca.
Please, has anyone
and when they asked for water, no water was given to them.
Calm down. I'm excited.
Go on.
No water was given to them.
Yes, okay.
And they were asking for water.
Okay.
So what did your prophet do? He cut their hands off.
Yes. From each side.
He put heated iron into their eyes.
Yeah, watch this.
And then never gave them water in the desert.
Good. Is this good or bad?
So torture. Is torture good or bad?
Is this good or bad?
Is torture good or bad? He's asking me.
I believe the Prophet did
this is typical Ali.
The Prophet, watch this.
Go on.
The Prophet did the best thing to those people. Good on them.
Killing them, yeah?
Now watch this, yeah?
Killing them is a good thing.
In my country, they say the last person who has the love laughs the best. Watch this.
Sahel Bukhari.
Watch this.
Can volume I one. And it's book two, three.
Is
I need space.
Why
do you need to make
is everybody ready?
A scene?
Is everybody ready?
What's the source of it?
3 weeks ago. 3 weeks ago, I dropped the mic.
Yes.
Today, I don't even need a mic.
Hadith 234.
1 second, brother, please allow me.
Does that hadith exist?
Brother, please allow me. Brother, this happened. This happened. This stuff certainly happened. Yes, it happened.
Okay,
hear me out, brother. May Allah bless you. Please allow me. Who were these people the Prophet did this to? Light on him, please.
So you haven't listened to what I read.
Who was the people that the Prophet plucked their eyes out, cut their, crucified them? Who are they?
Some people of Uraina
did what?
Tribe came to Medina and his climate did not suit them.
Go on.
So the Prophet ordered them to go to the herd, camels.
They refused them.
And wait. Why are you excited?
Sorry.
He's getting excited.
Forgive me.
Yeah, I do forgive you because I have Jesus.
You keep saying forgive me, but you keep
saying. So the prophet ordered them. Watch this. This is funny. It's a funny story.
It's gonna be funny.
To the herd of camels to drink their milk and their urine as a medicine. So the camel urine and milk is a medicine. Would you drink camel urine?
If it's a medicine, yes.
You
what?
Drink?
Would you drink camel urine?
If it's
proven, Muslims, do you drink camel urine?
Carry on.
Oh, silence.
Carry on.
I will carry on. So they went as directed, and after they became healthy,
yes.
And they killed a shepherd of the prophet.
Oh no, they didn't.
And drove away all the camels.
Oh no, they did not.
The news reached the prophet early in the morning, and he sent in their pursuit, and they were captured and brought them at noon. He then ordered to cut their hands off,
yes,
and put their eyes branded with heated, yes, pieces of iron.
Good. Was it? Did they deserve it?
No, they didn't.
Oh. Okay, let me get this.
Okay,
what was it?
Why are you laughing?
Let me get this right.
Even
Daniel.
Let me finish.
Please, brothers.
You said, did they murder somebody?
Listen.
They killed the shepherd of the prophet and drove away all the camels.
Yeah.
The news reached the prophet early in the morning,
yes,
and he sent them in their pursuit and were captured and, yes, brought at noon.
Yeah.
And what did your prophet do?
Take the eyes
out. Cut their hands off
and crucified them.
And then captured them,
yeah,
put heated pieces of, yes, iron in, yes, their eyes.
Yes. Good.
And then they were asking for water and no water was given to them.
Good. One second.
How can you say they deserved it?
One second. Good. I come to you. Listen carefully. I come to you. I go, I'm ill. I'm going to die. You say, you know what? I love Jesus. Yeah. There's my my mom, my family is there. Go to them. They're gonna give you some medicine. Eat from the nice food. Enjoy yourself. I say, Daniel, thank you so much. I head to where they.
Camerun is not medicine.
Let me finish. I go there. His family look after me. They treat me well. My illness is gone. And then I start chopping your mom, your brother's heads off, killing them. And then Daniel comes after me and punishes me by crucifying me, and you're the bad guy. You're mad. Night, night, brother. You are out of your mind.
If you follow Muhammad, this is what happens to you again and again. Drinking camel urine. Drinking camel urine makes you.
This is how you get.
Gives you a medicine.
This is embarrassing.
And this is what camel urine does to people. Goes around and killing people.
How could you expose your own self with your own words? With your own words,
bro. I read Sahel Bukhari. Sahel Bukhari exposed you. Sahel Bukhari exposed you.
I'm gonna drop a mic. It's finished.
So
with your own mouth, you said they killed the prophet and they got crucified. Good on them.
Okay.
The prophet did the best thing. We started.
With you not answering 600 to 900 Jews being killed justly.
God killed Jesus for not doing nothing. The prophet crucified them for killing the shepherd.
No, brother.
No more chances for you. You're disqualified.
Okay, you're done, yeah?
Red card.
He's walking away again. Running away.
Summarize for the camera.
Running away. Running away. I've got another hadith.
Do your research.
We've got more hadith.
I've got more hadith.
You're embarrassing.
Do you want more hadith?
He's quoting hadith that supports us.
Do you want more hadith? He doesn't want more hadith.
I'm going to go pray for you.
All right.
Maghrib, I need to go pray for you.
Basically, basically, Ali Dawa does not have any sources. He goes to Surah 33 and Surah 5. When I give Ibn Hisham 461 to 464 and Sahih al-Bukhari, he goes out of context. Why? Because he does not know the answers. And this is what Muhammad does to you. This is what Allah does to you. He confuses you. You think you know stuff, but you don't. You're really being deceived, but you don't know this. So what we're saying is Muhammad is not a mercy to mankind. No way he's mercy to mankind. He was a hater. He was a murderer. He was a warlord. That's what Muhammad was. But Jesus was the King of Kings, who is the light of the world. He said, love your enemies, pray for those who despitefully use you and persecute you. That's what Jesus said. If you are going to go and kill somebody, what happened in the Bible? Peter cut off the ear of the servants. Yeah? And what did Jesus say? Those who live by the sword will die by the sword. And then he went away and he healed
the heir of the servant called Malchukas. That's what Jesus did. He never fought him. When he said those people who live by the sword will die by the sword, he was talking about Muhammad, the warlord. Sword, sword, sword. But Jesus is all about love. He's the same yesterday and today forevermore. Come to know him. He will save your life forever. God bless you.
Yeah, I will.